Hi friends, I am Dr. Shanmukh Kuchpad. Today we will discuss important JEE and CET questions for applications of differentiation. So let us define the basic terminologies. So basic things we will discuss it now. If x is a variable, then dx upon dt represents the rate of change of x with respect to the time t. That is, here we observe that x is a dependent variable, t is an independent variable. Then if we differentiate y with respect to x, so we get a dy by dx. It is a rate of change of a y with respect to x. So next point, velocity of a particle v is ds upon dt. So s is called as a distance or displacement. So finding the first order differentiation of a particle, we call it as a velocity. Suppose that the given ds upon dt, you can concentrate here. So once again, if we differentiate, we get a second order differentiation as d square s upon dt square. The finding the second order differentiation, we call it as a acceleration of a particle. So next, when the body reaches maximum height at any point, point velocity is zero. Okay, it will stay for there for a some time, so velocity will be the zero, therefore it is taken as a zero. Now time of a ascent is always equal to the time of a descent. Initial velocity is the velocity when time taken as a zero, that is t equal to zero, then it is initial velocity. When the body comes to a rest momentarily, velocity is taken as a zero, as well as acceleration is taken as a zero. Now next important formula, all these are very important formulas, so those things are going to observe here. So area of a circle, a equal to pi r square, circumference of a circle is given by c equal to 2 pi r. Everyone take a note of this, so you can take a screenshot. I am going to stay for a one minute here. Yes, okay, fine. Yes, everyone take a screenshot of this. Yes. So remaining important formulas are there. Surface area of a cube is given by the formula s equal to 6x square. Area of a equilateral triangle, very important, many times we are going to use it, this a equal to root 3 by 4 x square, frequently used. See expression, it is height of a equilateral triangle is given by the formula h equal to root 3 by 2 x, like this we have. Area of a square is a equal to x square, like this, very important terminologies. You can take a screenshot of these things. Okay, so without much wasting a time, let us begin with the first example. So first example, I read out, a spherical ball is being inflated at the rate of 35 cc per minute. So the given things we will note it down. It is given that dv by dt equal to, it is 35 cc per minute. Then the rate of increase of a surface area of a balloon, we have to calculate. So surface area, that is a ds, is increasing or decreasing with respect to time. So divided by dt, we need to calculate. Question mark it is, when diameter is 14, diameter is 14 means, so radius half of that, so it is a 7 centimeter. Then we have to find the volume here, and then we can find the surface area. So volume of a spherical balloon, already we have discussed this. So this is given by the formula 4 divided by 3 pi r cube. Now we differentiate this one. If we differentiate, we get dv by dt equal to 4 by 3 into pi. R cube differentiation is 3 r square dr by dt, like this we are going to get it. So from a numerator and denominator, 3 get cancels, and dv by dt, so the value is 35, it is a given, and I am going to write from our last expression 4 pi as it is, 4 pi as it is. Then see, radius, it is a 7 centimeter, it is given. So 7 square, it is a 49. Yes, and dr upon dt. Okay, then if you write a solution for dr by dt, we are going to get dr by dt is equal to 5 by 28 pi. Now we will find the surface area. Surface area formula is given by S equal to 4 pi r square. So differentiate this one, we get a ds by dt equal to, it is a 4 pi as it is, r square differentiation is 2r with respect to t, dr by dt. Okay, now we have to substitute the value of r and dr upon dt. I'm going to get 4 pi is multiplied by 2 into 7, dr by dt, it is a 5 divided by 28 pi. Okay, so if you simplify this, so we are going to get pi pi will get cancels, we get a 10 square centimeter per minute. Okay, so now yes, we observe that second option is a right. Okay, yes, everyone, you can take a screenshot. This is a first page. Yes, this will be a second page like this. So quick calculation, you can find it the solution for, so ds by dt. Now let us move to our next example. A cylindrical tank of radius 10 meter is being inflated with a weight at the rate of 314 cubic meter per hour. The depth of the weight is increasing at the rate of, so we have to calculate that. So here it is given, volume is given, it is given that volume is dv by dt is 314, so cubic meter per hour, and dh by dt we need to calculate. I take it as a question mark, and radius is given, this is a 10 meter. Okay, then we use a formula, volume of a cylinder is given by the formula pi r square h. Dear students, all these formula beginning I have discussed. So pi as it is I am writing, r is 10 square is 100 into h. Okay, so we are going to get v as a pi 100 h. Then now we differentiate this one, we will differentiate. So v differentiation is dv by dt is equal to pi 100 constant is multiplied by 100, as it is I write it. H differentiation is dh by dt. Now I substitute the value of dv by dt. So dv by dt, it is a 314. Remaining things we write as it is, 100 as it is, pi as it is, dh by dt. Okay, now we have to simplify for dh by dt. Okay, dh by dt, we get 314, here it is a pi, 314 100 divided by pi, so pi is 3.14, so we get answer as a 1 meter per hour. Okay, therefore option A is a right answer. So here pi is 3.14, so they get cancels, we get a 1 meter per hour. Therefore see, first option is a right, you can take a screenshot of this. This is a first page. Yes, now this is a second page, right? So now we'll move to our next example. the rate of change of the area of a circle with respect to its radius r at r equal to 6 cm is. See, here we come across the geometry circle. So area of a circle, already we have discussed this formula, a equal to pi r square. This is area of a circle. Now we have to differentiate this one. A differentiation is dA by dr. With respect to r, we have to differentiate. So pi constant as it is associated with a variable. R square differentiation is a 2r. Then we have to substitute the value of r as a 6. So we get a 6 to the 12 pi as a answer. Therefore, option 2, 12 pi is a right answer. Okay. So here in this example, circle it is. So area of a circle we have to write, and we have to differentiate this one, substitute the r value, we get answer as a 12 pi. Everyone take a screenshot. Yes. So we'll move to our next example. Example number 4. The sides of an equilateral triangle are increasing at the rate of 2 cm per second. So in an equilateral triangle, all sides of a same length. So that same length, I take it as a x variable. So it is increasing with respect to time. So I can take this as a dx divided by dt equal to 2 cm per second. Then rate of which the area increases when the side is 10 cm. Okay. So I'm taking x equal to, the side is x. So I'm writing 10 cm it is. Okay. So further, so what we have to calculate, at what rate in which the rate is increasing. Yes. So we have to calculate the value of dA by dt. We take it as a question mark. Okay. Now area of a equilateral triangle. So we have defined it. So it is a equal to root 3 by 4 x square. Root 3 by 4 x square. Now we differentiate this one. We differentiate this one. So a differentiation is dA by dt. A differentiation is dA by dt equal to, now root 3 by 4 is a constant. Constant is associated with a variable. Then, so use a CU rule. Constant I have written as it is. X square differentiation is a 2x. X differentiation again with respect to time, dx by dt. Now we'll substitute the value of a dx upon dt. Yes, all these values x. So root 3 by 4 as it is into 2 as it is, x it is a 10, dx by dt it is a 2. Then so we are going to get the simplification as 10 root 3. Yes, 4 and this 4 get cancels, 10 root 3. The unit is centimeter square per second. So option 3 is a right answer. Okay, so we have written a corresponding formula, and we have differentiated all the values, we have substituted, and we got a solution for this. Everyone take a screenshot of our first page. Yes, yes, fine. So this is a second page. So option 3 is a right answer. Now let us do the next example. Yes, the question is, the radius of a circular plate is increasing at the rate of 0.01 centimeter per second. When the radius is 12 cm, then the rate of at which the area increases is. So here geometry is radius of a circle. So we have to take area of a circle, we have to take it. So a equal to pi r square. First we'll write all these given things. So the radius of a circle is increasing with respect to time. So this is taken as dr by dt is equal to 0.01. And next, radius is what? It is a 12, it is a given. Then da by dt is question mark. Then we'll write area of a circle is a equal to pi r square. So now we have to differentiate, and dr upon dt value we have to substitute, da upon dt we have to calculate. Very simple it is. So differentiating, so a differentiation is da by dt. So here constant is associated with a variable, constant write as it is. R square differentiation is 2r dr by dt, it is 2r dr by dt. So further dr by dt value we have to substitute, so pi as it is, 2 as it is, r is 12, and dr upon dt 0.01. okay, so if you simplify this, we are going to get 0.24 pi square units. So option A is a right answer. So everyone take a screenshot. This is a first page, this is a second page. Yes, thank you for watching this video. Thank you.